In 1992, senior policy analyst Robert Rector delivered a devastating critique of the federal government's war on poverty. He caused slack jaws throughout Washington by estimating that the government had spent more than $3.5 trillion in constant 1990 dollars in welfare spending since 1965. The result, after nearly three decades of federal bounty, 30 million Americans still lived in poverty. Rector stated that the real problem with welfare is not merely rapid expanding cost, absorbing over 4% of the national economy, but that welfare actually harms rather than helps the poor. The prolific spending had led to a dramatic increase in what he called behavioral poverty, the creation of a gigantic welfare constituency. The solution, Rector argued, was not the expenditure of more billions or even trillions of dollars, but comprehensive welfare reform with the following elements. Reduce benefits, especially aid to families with dependent children payments. Require work in return for benefits. Work fair instead of welfare. Require responsible behavior by those who receive benefits. Enforce education requirements. Initiate experiments such as bonuses to AFDC mothers who marry, leave AFDC, and remain off the welfare rolls. Provide tax credits or vouchers for medical coverage to all working families, and provide tax relief to all families with children. Those who have studied this issue recognize that Congress also recognized the wisdom of Rector's suggestions and incorporated many of them in the historic welfare reform legislation of 1996.